हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन।
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम।
आई थिंक एवरीवन नोइंग दैट टुडे इज इंटरनल टेस्ट ऑफ अलजेब्रा 2।
यस मैम। यस मैम।
इंटरनल एग्जाम्स, यू नो दैट इफ यू गेट 8 मार्क्स आउट ऑफ 20 मार्क्स यू विल बी पास एंड यू विल बी एबल टू गिव द एग्जाम। नो डाउट फॉर थ्योरी एग्जाम यू कैन गिव द एग्जाम बट इट विल नॉट बी काउंट इफ यू आर फेल्ड इन द इंटरनल। एंड yesterday we have created the we have found the list, those who are absent, that 75% present is compulsory, no? So those students, please communicate to Tinge ma'am if you want to really appear for the internal. Okay, so we were going to start the open cover. Okay, definition of open cover. Now we are going to start the compact set. Okay, I hope everyone knowing about or at least you heard the name compact set or compact space in our matrix spaces, right? Before knowing a compact set, we should know what is the definition of a open cover, and before that we should know what is a cover, right? So first we'll go for the definition of a cover, then open cover, then we'll come for the compact set. Okay. So firstly, what is a cover? The name itself suggests the meaning that it is going to cover your set. Okay. Suppose you have X is a universal set. Let A be the any subset of X. Then we are going to have a covering. Instead of going for the definition, first let us go for the real life example. I think in the school days you are having a notebook, and for the notebooks of homework you are having a cover, right? Khaki color ka jo cover lagate the na hum log, right?
Yes ma'am.
So that is nothing but the cover. In short, if you want to understand the definition of a cover, okay. Now next come the definition of a open cover. Now it will be there in our open sets or in mathematics itself. So cover itself is a simply definition of a cover is nothing but like your cover for a notebook, right? And open cover is nothing but suppose you are going to cover your notebook with the help of a open set. Okay, suppose you are going to cover your notebook with the help of a open set. So if you are covering your notebook with the help of a open set, then it is called a open cover. Okay, now suppose this is what a notebook, then how many cover I can put on a single notebook? Hello, hello, everyone able to hear me?
Yes ma'am.
Yes ma'am.
Now, just tell me how many covers you can put on a single notebook.
One.
No, how many possible covers I am saying? Ek cover dalne
ke liye many, infinitely many.
Yes.
Many can cover ma'am.
Yes, so we can say countable number of covers I can put on a single notebook.
Yes ma'am.
Okay. But how many actually needed to cover that book?
One is sufficient.
Okay, one is a sufficient. So which is what a finite number we can count to. And countable number of covers we can put on a single room. Okay. So is the idea clear about the cover and open cover in the real life? Now one more example is there. Everyone knowing the cabbage, who bhi pata hai sabko?
Yes ma'am.
It is having many covers, right? Even you are having onion, kanda, so it is also having many covers. So if you are going to open every cover, right, no doubt it is not a countable number, we can count them. Agar aap gobi ko bhi nikaloge to uske covers count kar sakte ho, or even we can count the number of covers in the onion, right? right? But when we have a question to which we are going to cover, क्योंकि अगर आप गोभी को गोभी के सारे कवर्स निकालोगे तो किस चीज को हमने कवर किया था. सो वी कैन कंसिडर वन स्मॉल पार्ट इन दैट इन साइड ऑफ कैबेज. सो वी कैन कंसिडर दैट टू बी अ वन सेट ए टू विच वी आर हैविंग अ कवरिंग. इन द ओनियन ऑल्सो वी कैन हैव अ सिंगल वन पार्ट ऑफ अ ओनियन विच वी कैन से इट इज अ सेट ए. टू द सेट ए वी आर गोइंग टू हैव अ कवर्स इन द ओनियन. Right, so we can say these are finite number of covers. Right, these are what are simply real life examples of the covering. Okay, now let us go for the definition of a cover, open cover and a compact sheet. Okay, so firstly the definition of a cover that we are going to see in our topology is, I will write here so that you can understand. Let X to be a T space and let A be the subset of X, then the family G alpha, or if you are confusing with G alpha, we can say it is A alpha, the family A alpha, where alpha belongs to the index set of subsets of X. Okay, of subsets of X is said to be open cover, or we can say simply cover, as we are having A alphas for A. Okay, it will be a cover for A if it satisfies the condition. But it that means A must be contained in that union of all A alpha, where alpha belongs to the index. Just like A is your notebook, or it is a one part of onion, and it is onion ko jo cover kiya tha humne, that is nothing but your A alphas. Okay, these are what covers, and here these are notebook. Okay, so many number of covers we can put on a single notebook, but how many actually require for covering is only single one, right? So let X to be a T space. First we should have a T space. Let A be the any subset of X, then A alpha nothing but the subsets of X. Okay, so A alphas are said to be the cover if they are going to satisfy the condition that A is contained in union of A alpha. If they satisfy this condition, then we say that it is a cover for a A. Have you understood the definition?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay, just remember the example of a onion, cabbage, and covering of a notebook. Then you can understand what are those A alpha. These are nothing but your covers of your notebook. Okay, so A is your notebook, and A alphas are the covers of a notebook. What are A alpha? These are subsets of X. As we are going to define in a mathematics, so we will have some set X, and A alphas are the subsets of X, and then we are going to cover that A with the help of A alphas, and that is called a cover, simply cover. Now, if I say that it is an open cover, then the definition will be changed somewhat. What is a change only? Instead of having A alpha, we can say it is a G alpha. What are G alpha? G alphas are nothing but your open sets. Okay, so we, instead of having simply A alphas or simply the subsets of X, okay, what are A alpha? We have collected them to be a subsets of X. Instead of them, we can collect the G alpha, and if we are able to collect such a open sets which covers A, then we can say that these are open. Okay, the definition is very same. The change is what? Only instead of having simply alpha, we can say it is open sets. Okay, instead of having subsets of X, we can say simply they are open subsets of X. And if we are able to collect such a open subsets of X, and if they satisfy the condition A is contained in union of all G alpha, where alpha belongs to the index set, then we say that these G alphas are nothing but the open covers. Okay, so we can say these G alphas are open cover for a set A. Okay, the definition is very similar to cover, only the change is what, instead of taking any subset of X, we can take the open subsets of X, and if satisfy the condition, then they are called as a open covers. Now let us go for the next definition, compact set. Okay, before knowing this compact set, we should know cover and open cover. So that's why First, what is given to us? Let X2 be a topological space, a T space. That means 2 is a topology on X. Let A be the any subset of X. Then A set, then the set A is said to be compact. Then set A is said to be compact if any open cover of A has a finite subcover. If any open cover of A has a finite subcover. Okay, just like a subset, we have a subcover. Just like I told you, how many actually require for covering a notebook is a single one, that we can say it is a subcover. Okay, which one is a finite one, no? Only one cover is a require, which is a subcover, and many number of cover that we have applied on a notebook, these are what are open covers. Okay, now I hope you have studied this type of a definition. But many time in the metric space or in the BSc, we are using the definition of a compact set, a compact space as a closed and bounded, no?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so actually it is not a definition, closed and bounded. This is what one theorem which we have studied, that we are having a compact set or compact space. Then if and only if statement is there, that that set will be a closed and bounded. So don't assume that that is a definition. There are so many aspects about the definition, that it is closed and bounded, then it is a compact set. So it is not a definition. So actual definition is what? A is said to be compact if any open cover of A has a finite subcover. Okay, just like the thing we have told, that for we are having a many covers for a single notebook, we can say this is what a open cover. जो भी हमने एक्स्ट्रा कवर्स लगाए थे नोटबुक पे वो क्या है? ओपन कवर. एंड व्हाट इज अ फाइनाइट सब कवर? दैट अ सिंगल कवर व्हिच इज सफिशिएंट टू कवर योर नोटबुक इज कॉल्ड अ फाइनाइट सब कवर. ओके, इफ एनी ओपन कवर ऑफ ए हैज अ फाइनाइट सब कवर, देन वी से दैट ए इज अ कॉम्पैक्ट सेट. इज इट द आइडिया क्लियर अबाउट द कॉम्पैक्ट सेट?
यस मैम.
और इन नोटेशंस आई कैन राइट दिस एज the set A will have one open cover, say G alpha, which belongs to the index set, and we can say this open cover has some finite sum subcover, say G alpha I, where I runs from 1 to n. That n may be single one also. Okay, in the case of notebook, n is equal to 1, so this many number of a cover for a notebook will have a sufficiently, only one cover is sufficient. And then we can say this is what your notebook, and this is a single cover, and these are many number of cover. So any open cover, if it has a finite subcover so that it covers your A, then we can say that the A is a compact set. Okay, any doubt for this definition? Cover, open cover, compact set?
No ma'am.
If not, let's go for the next one, that is discrete T space. Okay, now we will take any subset A of X in case of a discrete T space. What do you mean by discrete T space? 2 is equal to power set of X. And A is any subset of X. Then we will find out whether any subset of a discrete topological space is a compact or not. Okay, so for that, first we will go for a set X itself. Okay. First, we'll check for X itself, whether X is a subset of X itself, no? So, we'll first find out the open cover and finite subcover for X itself, and then we'll go for the subset if it is possible. Right? Agar X hi compact nahi hoga, toh uske subsets ko check karne ka zarurat nahi hai, na? Right? I hope you are knowing the theorem. Closed subset of a compact space is a compact.
Yes, ma'am.
If your set is compact, then only we can go for checking the subsets are compact or not. So first we'll check for X. X is a subset of X itself. Then we will find out the open covers, and then we'll check whether there exists a finite subcover which covers X. Okay. Now, as we are in a general case for discrete t-space, we know that for a discrete t-space, tau is equal to power set of x. We can take x to be a finite set, right? Or in another way, we can say x is a infinite set. Okay, we can have x to be infinite, finite, countable, uncountable. So if I want to have a consideration for in general, so we will select x to be some infinite set, and then we will verify that whether x will be able to have a finite subcurve. Okay, so x is equal to, I can write x as a union of all singleton x, where x belongs to capital X, because every singleton x is a member of tau, because it is a member of a power set of x. Is it okay?
Yes, ma'am.
So here we have found the open cover for x, right? Now we have to check whether this open cover has a finite subcurve. Yes, can you find out the finite subcurve for this one?
No, ma'am.
Okay. Since we have considered x to be infinite, but if suppose I have considered x to be a finite, x jar finite asel tar tela jo open cover ahe tej finite subcover act karu shakto na.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, suppose x is, I have written x as a a b c, and if I have found the open cover is union of all a singleton b singleton. So this is itself is a open cover and itself is a finite subcover, because it is covered by finite number of element, na? That is, I can write union of A with B with C, and this itself will a finite subcover. Okay, because singleton A is a member of tau, na? Singleton A, singleton B, singleton C, all are members of tau, since we have tau is equal to power set of X. Okay. Since in power set of x, these all singleton x are the members of tau, so that we can say this is what a open cover. Okay, now let us check we are able to find out the finite subcover. So if x is a infinite set, so how x is an infinite set can be able to cover with the finite number of singleton sets, right now? X अगर इनफाइनाइट है तो उसको फाइनाइट नंबर ऑफ सिंगलटन सेट्स के फॉर्म में नहीं लिख सकते ना.
यस यस मैम.
यस मैम.
सो हियर वी कैन से x इज व्हाट इनफाइनाइट सेट, सो इट कैन नॉट बी रिटन एज यूनियन ऑफ ऑल द सिंगलटन x, वेयर x वी आर टेकिंग टू हैव अ फाइनाइट नंबर ऑफ ओपन. सो दिस इज नॉट पॉसिबल, सो हेंस वी कैन से x2 इज नॉट अ compact space. If you are writing the x2, then you have to write down the space, and if you are simply writing x, then we can say x is not a compact set. Okay, and what is compact space? That means if x2 is satisfying this condition, then we can say it is compact space. So we can say x2 is not a compact space and x is not a compact set. So you can have a remark here, or you can now again construct that table in which you have to write down the property, which one is a compact set and which one is not a compact set. Let us go for the next one, the indiscrete t-space in which tau is equals to phi and x. Now let us consider A be the any subset of x, or we can have we can first check for x, then we'll find out whether it has a finite subcurve. Okay, now can you say me whether x has any open cover in case of indiscrete t-space? Can you have the many number of open sets which covers x?
X itself.
No, ma'am.
X itself is going to cover itself. I can say x is written as union of x itself. वो खुद को ही cover कर सकता है ना? Is it not obviously that we should have a different open set? So how many open set actually we have? These two open set. So x itself cover x. So this itself is a open cover, and hence as it is a finite number, so we can say itself is a finite subcurve. So x is covered by a finite number of open set. X is open set, ahe na? because we have only two open set, phi and x. So we can say x is covered by this, and this is what a open cover, and this is what a finite subcover, which implies x2 is a compact space. Okay, so we can have a remark in case in we have a discrete topology, it is not a compact, and in discrete T space is a always a compact space. Is the idea clear about the discrete and indiscrete T space?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
If you have a doubt, you can ask me. If not, let us go for the next one. Any compact subset of a T2 space is a closed. Any compact subset of T2 space, or the statement is like this: any compact subset of a Hausdorff space is closed. Instead of T2, they can give the statement as Hausdorff space. Any compact subset of a Hausdorff space is closed, or we can have a statement: any compact subset of a T2 space is a closed. Okay. So, can anyone tell me what is given to us and what we want to prove? स्टेटमेंट है ना कॉम्पैक्ट सबसेट ऑफ टी टू इज क्लोज्ड
सबसेट ऑफ टी टू इज गिवन एज कॉम्पैक्ट सो वी हैव टू प्रूव दैट इट इज क्लोज्ड
ओके What is given to us? We have any compact subset of a T2 space. First, we'll write down it X2 is a T2 space. Okay, we are provided that X2 is a T2 space. Let A be the subset of X and A is a compact. Given that A is a compact. What is our aim to prove that? A is a closed. Is the idea clear? What is given to us and what we want to prove? Okay, any compact subset of T2 space. So up to now, we have to first write down X2 is a T2 space. Any compact subset means first we have to take a subset of X, any subset, and we have to take A as a compact. Then is closed means we have to prove that A is a closed set. Okay, to prove that A is closed, what do you mean to prove A is closed? That is to prove that X minus A is open.
Open.
Okay, because to prove open sets in a topology is easier. Okay. Now given to us as it is a T2 space and a compact. Okay, two properties are given, but we can use the definition of T2 space only if we are able to find out two distinct points. Okay, and we will able to use a definition of a compact set if we have an open cover. Okay, if we are able to find out open cover, then we can use a definition of a compact space. Barobar na?
Yes, ma'am.
See, what is the definition of compact space? Any open cover has a finite subcover. So first we should able to find out open cover. Jar open cover disla tumhala tar tumhi sangu shakta ki he compact set hai ani ha open cover la finite subcover exist hoto. Right? And if you want to prove it is a compact set, then you have to start with the open cover and find out the finite subcover. Okay, there are two different aspects. to prove a compact set and to use the definition of a compact set. To use a definition, we should have an open cover. Then you can use the definition to prove that it is a compact set. So first you have to start with the open cover. Okay, start with the open cover and prove that you have a finite subcover. नाहीतर काय करतात आपण एग्जाम मध्ये आता तर तुम्हाला पॉसिबल नाही आहे फिजिकल एग्जाम साठी लेटर ऑन यू विल कम टू नो इफ इट इज अ फिजिकल एग्जाम ओके कंसीडर ए बिलोंग्स टू ए फर्स्ट वी विल टेक अ सिंगल एलिमेंट ए फ्रॉम कैपिटल ए राइट एंड कंसीडर दैट वी हैव टू डिफरेंट एलिमेंट इन कैपिटल ए लेट ए इज नॉट इक्वल टू एक्स इन capital X, okay, and if we are saying that A and X both are different element in capital X, then we can use a definition of a, okay, let me show you how it looks. This is what X, and suppose A is some set here which contains element A, right, and X is somewhere here. Right, A and X both are different element. A is element of A, X is element of capital X, and both are different in X. So now we have A is not equal to X in capital X. Now we can use a definition of a T2 space. Correct? Because we are not having a two different element up to now. Now we have a two different element. So by using the definition of a T2 space. Since X2 is a T2 space, so there exists GX, GA belongs to O such that, what such that X belongs to GX, A does not belongs to GX, and A belongs to GA, and X does not belongs to GA. Is the idea clear? I have written the suffix so that we can understand X is belonging to GX, A is belonging to GA. Okay. So in the diagram, we can write this as, this is what your X, this is an element A, this is X, and this is the set A, right? And we can say this is what GA, which contains element A, and this is what GX, which contains element X. As it is a T2 space, we should have GA and GX intersection is empty set, because we have to find out the disjoint open set in case of a T2 space, right? GX intersection GA is empty set in case of a T2 space. Simply we have used a definition. Okay. Now, what we can say now, first we can say A is covered by union of all singleton A. Is it okay? I can write capital A as a union of all singleton A. This is possible, right? Because any set, if you are not knowing what are the elements of that set, you can write that set in the form of a singleton sets. Now, what is our aim to find out? First, we should be able to find out the open cover. If you are able to find out the open cover, then you can say that as A is a compact set, we have a finite subcover. Okay. To use a definition of a compact set, first we should have a open cover. Right. So let me find out the open cover. I can find out the open cover as union of all GA such that A belongs to capital A. Right. So what we can say, this is what set A. Set A mein kya hai? Sabhi elements hai na? Every element is there here. So every element I have written in the form of a singleton set. Now, as we are able to find out the open set containing the single element A, I can find out many number of the open sets which contains every single element, or it may contain more than one element. Right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, every element may be contained in one of the open set. Okay, ए के सभी एलिमेंट के लिए हमने एक ओपन सेट फाइंड आउट किया और वी कैन से ए इज कवर्ड बाय सम फाइनाइट नंबर सम ओपन सेट्स. ओके सो वी कैन से दिस शोज दैट ए हैज अ ओपन कवर. ओके how it is possible, first we have written a as a union of all singleton sets and every single element, for every single element we can find out the open set ga, right? This is possible because we have written here that for x not equal to a, okay, for two different element we can find out the two different open set. Okay, as x and a both are arbitrary elements, so that's why for any arbitrary element we can find out the open set with the help of a definition of a T2 space. Okay, try to find out the finite subcover. Okay, what is given to us, A is a compact set, so we can use the definition of a compact set. Any open cover of A has a finite subcover. It implies that A has a finite subcover, right? Simply we have written A as a union of all GA, where A belongs to capital A. And this open cover, we can say it has a finite subcover GAI, where I runs from 1 to N, okay? So any open cover has now a finite subcover by using the definition of a compact set. Okay, now we will find out a G, capital G, such that it is GX1 intersection GX2 intersection GX3 intersection and so on intersection GXN. Okay, you will understand how we have formed this later on. What is our aim actually? We have to prove A is a closed set. To prove that A is a closed set, it is sufficient to prove that X minus A is open set. Remember what we want to prove. Okay, simply we are using the definitions or the consideration which we are given. First we have used the definition of a T2 space. Then we have used the definition of A is compact. Now we have to find out that whether x minus a is open. Agar x minus a open hoga to a close hoga, right? So let us consider g as a union of all, intersection of all gx, right? What is gx? Gx is a open set containing x. Okay, here we have written gx is a open set containing x. So what will be the intersection of GXI with GAI?
Empty
set, because these are what, two different open sets containing two different element, right? So I can write this in the form of union also. Iska union or iska union agar hum lenge to wo bhi empty aayega, right? So let me write down this, which implies GXI is contained in GAI complement or in another way I can say GAI is contained in GXI complement. Just like the thing we have written, A intersection B is empty, then A is contained in B complement. Barabar? And B is contained in A complement. These two are possible. So intersection of these two is empty, so we can write one of the things. Okay. So firstly, we should find out what is A. Okay, A we have written with the help of GA, and it can be covered by finite number of a open set. So hence, what is this GAI, its complement? We can say this is nothing but, we can say right, GXI, if you take the union on both sides, GXI is contained in this, I can say it is X minus A. Okay, because your GAI is nothing but your A now. So we can say this is A complement. So the same thing I can write in the by taking the union on both sides, we can say the complement of this. You can see this statement. A is contained in union of GAI, which means that A is covered by GAI. Okay, so we can have, if you take the union, it will be completely A. So A is equal to GAI, its complement means I can write this one, and this G set is nothing but intersection of GXI, and hence we can write this is what G is contained in X minus A. Okay, what is this G? G is a open set containing X, right? No, this is what the intersection of all the open set containing X, right? G is the intersection of all the open sets containing X. So we can say X belongs to G. Is the idea clear up to now?
Yes, ma'am.
It is somewhat difficult to understand, but simply you have to consider the set. First, you have to use the definition of T2, then use the definition of a compact, then simply find out one open set, which is the intersection of all the open set containing X. Okay, if it is an intersection of all the open set containing X, so obviously that intersection contains the element X. And hence, we have found X belongs to G, G is contained in X minus A. So this is what the definition of a, or we can say the one of the property of the interior of the set. Right, no? Samajhte ka, X minus A saathi apan open set G, फाइंड आउट केला ज्यात आपल्याला एलिमेंट एक्स मिळतोय, राईट? सो वी कॅन टेक द एक्स बिलॉंग्स टू एक्स मायनस ए, बरोबर ना? इज इट ओके? लेट मी शो यू व्हॉट वी हॅव. व्हॉट इज अ कन्सिडरेशन? ए इज अन एलिमेंट ऑफ ए, बट एक्स इज नॉट अन एलिमेंट ऑफ ए, राईट? X is outside element of A. So where X will belong, if X is not a member of A, obviously X will belongs to X minus A. Correct?
Yes, ma'am.
So if we are saying that X is outside member of A, it will belongs to its complement. So simply the same thing I have written here. X belongs to X minus A. And here we are able to find out the open set G which satisfy this condition. Okay. What condition is satisfied? For every element of X minus A, we are able to find out one open set G which is containing that element and which is contained in X minus A. Okay. So we can say for any element of X minus A, there exists the open set G which satisfy this condition, which implies X is an element of A interior, moreover by definition of A interior, or the theorem which we have seen related to A interior. Those who don't remember, go to the definition of A interior, and after the definition of A interior, we have proved one theorem. If X is an element of A interior, then there exists at least one open set which satisfy the condition X belongs to G, G is contained in X minus A. Okay, so hence X is a interior point of x minus a. So x is arbitrary point we have selected, and that arbitrary point belongs to a interior. What it means? X is arbitrary point of a, x minus a, and x is now the interior point, which implies I of x minus a is equal to x minus a. Sorry, here I should write down x minus a, it's interior. Okay, since it satisfies the condition that for every element of x minus a, we are able to find out the open set G, which satisfies the condition x is element of G, G is contained in x minus a. Those who don't remember, go back to the definition where you can understand this one. Okay, so hence we can say x is an element of x minus a, it's interior. So I can say interior of x minus a is equal to x minus a, which implies x minus a is a open set. Here you can again write down the statement of theorem. What is the statement? A interior is equal to A if and only if A is a open set. Right now? So x minus a interior is equal to x minus a, which means that x minus a is open, hence a is a closed set. Have you understood? Let me start with the first one. Okay, what is given to us? X2 is a T2 space, A is a compact set, and our aim is to prove that A is a closed. To prove that A is a closed, it is sufficient to prove that x minus a is a open. To prove that x minus a is open, I have to prove that A interior is equal to A. Okay, many theorems you have to remember whenever you are going to prove any theorem in the topological space. So A interior is equal to A if and only if A is a open set. This property or this theorem we are going to use. Okay, so for that, first we have taken an element for A, and A and X both are completely different element. X is not an element of A. So X will be element of its complement. Okay, and with the help of that, we have found two different elements. If we are able to find out two different elements by using the definition of a T2 space, we can say that there exists the two different open sets. Okay, we have got now two different open sets, Gx and Ga. And hence, you can see now, Gx and Ga are the two different open sets. Now, simply we have written A as a union of all the singleton sets, since we want to use the definition of a compact set. Okay, to use the definition of a compact set, first we should able to find out the open cover. Okay, this shows that the A has an open cover. How we have found the open cover? Since for every element of A, we can find out the open set by using T2 space. Is the idea clear up to now?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, and then we have used the definition. So we have a finite subcover. Then we have applied that. We have a one open set G, which is intersection of all the GXI. Then simply use the condition of A intersection B is empty, which implies A is contained in B complement. And use one theorem related to interior. Okay, many theorems we have seen related to interior, closed set, closure. So at that time, you should able to remember which property or which theorem you have to apply. So you can say X is an arbitrary element. We have proved that arbitrary element is a member of interior, which implies that A interior is equal to A, or we can say interior of X minus A is equal to X minus A. And using the theorem, we get the result x minus a is a open, which implies that a is a closed. Okay. No doubt it is somewhat difficult to understand, but you have a practice for that, and then you can come. Okay. So let us end the lecture here, because next theorem is again lengthy one. And in the afternoon session, I will take one practical session at 2:30 itself. Okay? Thank you.